So in previous space videos, I've talked about Mars and the five dwarf planets. In this video, however, I think we should leave our solar system and talk about exoplanets, which the term basically means any planet that exists outside of our solar system. But because of the stupid amount of exoplanets that exist, I'll just choose four planets at random and then talk about those. One thing I should preface before we go right in is that exoplanet studies are still relatively new, the first one being discovered in the early 90s, and also some planets that I'll be talking about today may or may not be 100% confirmed, as the data is still being developed as we speak, but for the sake of content, I'll talk about them anyway. Kepler-452b was announced in July 2015 by NASA using the transit method of discovery. This method is basically viewing a planet or celestial body as it passes in front of its host star, which in turn causes the emitted light from said star to dim a little bit. And while we're talking about it, the transit method is basically the most common and effective method of discovery, so that's pretty cool, I think. Anyway, 452b is fairly similar to Earth and is currently believed to lie within the habitable zone of its host star, meaning it may have the potential to harbor life. Located 1,400 light-years away from us, 452b orbits a G-type main-sequence star, which is the same as our sun, and also has 5 times the mass of Earth. 452b's orbit is only 20 days longer than ours at 385 days, however, the length of a day on this planet is currently unknown. Because 452b's star is towards the end of its lifespan and giving off more heat, the planet is likely experiencing a greenhouse effect, which causes its surface to reach around 17 degrees Celsius and is probably going to get hotter and hotter over time. However, if the planet has an ocean, that along with its volcanic activity due to its higher mass and density, that could help slow down this rapid heating by forming a carbon-silicate cycle. I have no idea what it is, go look it up, which could delay this process for around 500 million years. Moving on. Discovered a long time ago in the era of January 2024, astronomers discovered this planet in the constellation Gemini called HD 6343-3D. What's interesting about this planet is that it's tidally locked to its star that it's really close to, and has extreme weather on either side. HD orbits its star at around 0.05 astronomical units, or 1/20th the distance from the Earth to the Sun, which is horrendously close, as Mercury's distance is only 1/3 the distance of Earth and the Sun. And the distance gives the planet a 4-day orbital cycle. So the front side of this planet is scorching hot at over 1,200 degrees Celsius, and is believed to be covered in lava and magma, and has possibly a lot of volcanic activity. But conversely, the dark side of this planet is believed to be as cold as the dwarf planet Pluto, which is freezing cold at negative 230 degrees Celsius. The cold side of the planet also probably has a bunch of like frozen nitrogen glaciers moving about. So if you want to visit the real life equivalent to hell as possible, I recommend visiting HD. PSR B1620, nicknamed Methuselah after the longest living biblical figure according to various religions, is one of, if not the oldest exoplanets discovered, believed to be over 12 billion years old. Located over 12,000 light years away in the constellation of Scorpius to the right of Antares, Methuselah orbits a set of binary stars, one being a white dwarf and the other being a pulsar. A pulsar is a type of neutron star that rotates like really fast and is very magnetic, and this specific star is slightly larger than our sun, and is believed to rotate around over 100 times a second. Given the fact that it orbits a neutron star, how did Methuselah survive the supernova that created it? The answer, it probably didn't. Although uncertain, scientists think that Methuselah originated in its own solar system within the M4 cluster of stars until it traveled through the core of a cluster where it attracted a neutron star and its companion. After a lot of spinning around each other, rest in peace the companion, the original star swelled up into a supergiant, somehow avoiding Methuselah, then became a dwarf, and the neutron star kept spinning around it into a pulsar, and they lived happily ever after. Alright, the final planet we'll look at today is TOI 1452b, which is believed to be a planet completely covered in water. TOI was discovered in July 2022 at the University of Montreal, and data suggests that it is an ocean world candidate and is 70% larger than Earth and 5 times more massive. As you probably know, Earth is covered in 70% water, but that only accounts for less than 1% of its mass. On this planet, though, we're actually unsure, but based on the fact that it has a lot of water, probably, it could have oceans tens of hundreds of kilometers deep. Also, I want to recommend going swimming in the water here, as the surface temperature is over 50 degrees Celsius. So I just recommend sticking to your regular beach or swimming pool. So those are the four exoplanets that I thought were interesting and wanted to share with you guys today. And I'm thinking for whenever the next outer space video releases, I'll talk about some stars or some black holes or some other massive stuff. But my next video will probably be about like politics or something like that. I don't know. I'm thinking about the idea. All right, see ya.